I have a full-length yin yoga practice for you today. Yin is a passive practice. We'll hold the poses 2 to 5 minutes, just depending. You might see me looking at my watch or at my clock just to keep us honest so that we're holding long enough. I'm gonna use a couple of props today, yoga blocks and a blanket. Grab whatever you feel like is gonna make you comfortable. Bolster, pillows from your couch, right? It doesn't have to be quote unquote yoga props, just whatever you've got lying around that can help you to feel a little bit more supported is going to be super helpful. All right, so we're gonna start in child's pose. And if child's pose feels okay for you, just straight up on your mat, head down, go there. That's what I'm gonna try. If you're not feeling particularly comfortable yet in your hips, you might take a blanket and prop it behind your knees. You might have a bolster here to rest on, just depending on how you would prefer to feel that from the get-go. So once you get yourself sort of settled in, take your head down. And we'll just start to take some slow, deep breaths in and out through the nose. Feeling how your body moves as you breathe. On your inhales, feeling things expand all through your torso. Your chest, your belly, your sides, your back. Watching that expansion recede slowly and contract inward as you exhale. From time to time, feel free to exhale through your mouth like a sigh. Sometimes that can help us to release a little extra tension we may be holding on to. Looking straight down in your child's pose, let's turn the head to the right. We'll hang up here for a few breaths. Let's turn head to the left. You may feel some stretch in your neck. Let's take the head back to center.
Let's take a couple more full deep breaths here. Okay, and then let's slowly walk up out of that folded child pose. Coming upright, we may need a moment to let that settle, right? Bring your knees more in line with your hips if they were wide. Take your hands down, and let's tuck the toes under and see if we can maybe get those pinky toes to play along. You can keep your hands down and just give a little push. This is a toe squat position. If you're not really feeling a whole lot, because maybe you just have a little bit more mobility in your feet, you can come up to sit on your heels here. That it's important to stretch our feet as well, right? They're our foundation, everything's connected. Sometimes we are neglectful of our feet. We might wear crappy shoes, right? And that can cause a lot of problems. Even though I really like this one, I can't hold it quite as long as some of the other yin postures, right? It's a little intense. From here, I'm going to release the toes and then come to kneeling for just an easy camel, so no need to necessarily reach back for your heels. I'm going to put my hands on my hips and low back to help give me some support, feeling some lift through the chest, hands helping me to find a little bit more length. You can place your head wherever feels like it's gonna help your neck to feel okay. So you can continue to look straight ahead. Maybe gradually looking a little more up. Maybe the head drops back after a little bit. Breathing. Here, carefully lifting up and then keeping the toes pointed, bring my legs a little closer together. We'll try sitting on the heels. If that's too much, a couple things you can do. You can prop your hips up with a pillow or a block. You can also pad your ankles with a blanket underneath. Right, again, if you have a little bit more mobility in your ankles, your feet here, you may not be feeling a whole lot just yet. And from there, you can have your hands down and try lifting your knees. Your hands don't necessarily have to be down, right? This one's called ankle stretch for obvious reasons. I do like to state the obvious sometimes. And maybe, you know, you come into that back position and take a rest. Maybe try it one more time. No forcing, right? Remembering we are attempting a passive practice.
forward-facing dog next, as a counter position and a prep position for the next yin posture. If you are feeling like not really going up into a down dog today, maybe just come into table and do a little wiggling or a little cat-cow, right? And that'll be fine too, and it's a little bit more passive. After doing the toe squat and ankle stretch, I feel like down dog feels pretty good to get into and to just sort of move and paddle the feet a little bit. All right, so you can decide which one you like. Okay, and then from here, let's widen the feet to the edges of the mat. Toes can turn out a little bit. And we're gonna walk the hands back for squats. Right, now that we've stretched feet and ankles, right, we'll work them a little bit more here and also start to say hello to the hips. So if you maybe are not super mobile in your Achilles area, you can take a blanket and step your heels on top of it. Another way to make this a little friendlier is to sit on prop, right? Which actually I think feels wonderful and restful and easy, right? So maybe even if normally your squat feels pretty good, maybe you do a little bit of time with prop, come back to without the prop, see what changes. You can do whatever feels right with your arms. Just start to notice while you're on your feet here, if you have a tendency to be in one area of your foot balance-wise than another, and maybe that's more toward the toes or more toward the heels. Maybe it's more toward a pronation or supination, right, in or out toward the arch or the outer edge of the foot. See if you can just draw some attention there and maybe even things out a little bit more. Right, that prop is helpful when the shins start to feel a little bit of fatigue, which they do, holding that squat. Just a couple more deep breaths here. Okay. From here, we're going to lift up into dangling. Walk the feet a little closer together so they're more hip width. Knees are bent at least a little bit, right? We want to pay careful attention to how the lower back is feeling. And maybe we need to rest the arms and the legs to give us a little bit more support. You might have hands on blocks, right? And you might just need to keep your back a little bit straighter here, right? Sometimes if we're experiencing discomfort in the lower back, sometimes it's a little bit too rounded there. A little throne to rest your head on if you are a little bit lower in that dangle. one way to get the upper body to just hang a little bit heavier is to grab opposite elbows, right? That affords a little upper arm stretch as well. Feels kind of nice on my shoulders. Try a few different variations while you're here, right? You might bring back some of that awareness of what's going on with your feet since we're on them, like we were in that squat. Right, maybe just sort of shifting weight a little bit. Sometimes I like to circle. You might add some neck stretching by finding finger clasp hands behind your head and pulling a little bit, tucking the chin. Couple more nice deep breaths here. Okay. I'm going to scooch my props more forward for the next thing. So from here, I'm going to walk my hands forward and then get the right foot forward in a lunge position. Right, we're gonna hang out and move a little bit in this position, which is called fire breathing dragon, right? So we're not gonna hold it super long, but we're gonna use it as a prep position for the next yin posture, right? So just sort of wiggle around a little bit here, side to side, front to back. Bend and straighten with the front leg. Getting things just a little bit more warmed up through the hips. And you could, right, always use some propping to help that feel just a little bit friendlier. Rotating in and out with the front leg. I can't really see that probably. And that's going to get us set up for the next posture, which is swan or sleeping swan if you want to fold, right? Which is just like when we do pigeon in our more active styles of yoga. So we'll hold it a little bit longer and we'll try to let ourselves be a little more passive. So, get your props. Make sure things feel extra comfy. All right, so maybe you want pillows, blankets under hips. If you have something under your abdomen here, right? I'm going to put a block under my head. So the folded facing down variation. be a little bit more restful for most of us, but certainly staying upright is okay too. Maybe a little of both. We're breathing and scanning. Making sure that we're not trying to grip or hold anywhere. Sometimes we can inadvertently grip or hold tension in areas that are really just unrelated to the stretch that we're in. So while you're here, check in with your spine and your neck and your shoulders, your face. Make sure you're still breathing well. Let out sighs as needed. And like in some of the other positions, we're in, adding a little variety can sometimes just help us stay a little bit longer. Again, maybe that's the upright variation. Maybe you want to add a little more attention. Sometimes I say love, but it doesn't always feel like it for the back leg. All right, sometimes I'll add a little shoulder stretch. This one, you can do whatever feels right. Okay, a couple more deep breaths. Okay, let's carefully come up. You can set your prop aside. And then I'm going to go into down dog in between. All right, if that's too much for you today, maybe just kind of come into table and do a little wiggling, right? Maybe that hip needs a little bit of movement, so you can do a little circling. Maybe do that and then try a down dog. Okay, and then from here we'll get the left foot forward from that little bit of moving and rocking. Maybe a little side to side movement. A little straight leg action. Swan leg. Okay. When you feel ready, let's go ahead and get that swan position set up. Right, we'll just sort of take a moment, see how things feel. And then maybe we feel like some propping would feel nice. Under either hip, under abdomen, head, right? Experiment and see what feels good. As you start to settle in, check back in with your breathing. And take a scan. Encourage everything to soften and be passive. Nice deep breaths. That you have, right? Some options, some variations, right? If you're feeling the need, or maybe just getting a little bit antsy, staying in that one position, right? Maybe try coming up right. Maybe a little bit more attention for the back leg, like grabbing hold, giving a little tug. Maybe that shoulder stretch, like thread the needle.
some of each of those. Okay, if you're in down dog, let's drop the knees. We're gonna come onto our bellies for Sphinx Pose. Right, so base position is elbows about under the shoulders. I like my just a little bit forward of that. Make sure that your legs have scooched back, right, so that there's lots of space for your pelvis, your belly to rest. Right, and you can experiment with your props here for supports. You can pad under your abdomen. You can let something hold your head up. Right. We'll chill out here for a little bit. You start to settle into the shape, right? You may need to adjust a little bit, right? If you start to lose the sensation of the back bend, maybe you need to lift a little higher, right? Maybe seal, right? With elbows lifted. Sometimes I go up there and decide, come right back down, just how I'm feeling today. I do like a little bit of neck stretching in Sphinx as well. You can bring your chin down toward your chest, feel some back of the neck stretching, and kind of go up and down. Right, cervical cat-cow. Side to side. I'm in a little bit more stillness. Couple more deep breaths.
Okay, so from here, I'm going to go into a sequence of two poses linked together, and it really made a lot of sense for me to transition into this from being up here on my elbows. So next pose we're going to try is cat pulling its tail, which I just think the name is awesome. All right, so I'm going to roll onto my right side. I'm still going to have that elbow down. All right, top leg is the left leg. That'll be out in front. And then you might have to adjust a little bit, bending the bottom knee. I'm going to grab that foot in a second to get a little more quad stretch. But first, I'm going to bring a block up under me, and you could use pillows, bolsters, what have you, just so I'm a little bit more supported, right? I don't have to work as hard with that arm. And that also serves as maybe a little trigger point release for some little gnarly spots that you might have on your side body up near the armpit. Okay, so we'll hang out here for a little bit. You can grab your foot and kind of pull in towards your hips to feel a little quad stretching. Or you can get a little more loungy if you like. We are going to be reclining all the way in the next position. So maybe if you normally like this pose a little more reclined, stay up for just a little while, because we're going to go to more of a reclined twist in just a moment. This is more of our prep for that. You can get into that trigger point release a little more with some movement. Forth there. That's very interesting for me today. Okay, so to get into our reclined twist from here, I'm going to let go of that foot. All right, I'm going to just kind of carefully come up off of that block. Right now I've got bottom knee bent, top leg straight. I'm going to switch that. So we'll straighten the bottom leg, bend the top knee, and you might decide to set that on top of a block. Right, take the right arm and reach it out. And then from here, right, working toward being a little bit more reclined, you may have to scoot a little bit to the right, and you can take your left arm out to the left, or maybe even overhead, right, for something a little different, right, decide how you wanna experiment with that. And this propped up leg, right, your block has different heights. You can look over either shoulder.
your breathing. Check your neck and shoulders. Relax your face. Take a couple more deep breaths here. Okay. So I'm going to move my props out of the way. Right. And remember our sequence of poses. So we'll need to come back more toward our belly, so roll more toward your side, and then you might come all the way down to your belly and take a little wiggling from there. Alright, and then we'll prop back up on the elbows, roll over to the left side. Get that block underneath us. All right, top leg extends forward. All right, bottom knee bends. Cat pulling its tail. Right, may have to, you know, adjust a little bit. Right, that block is feeling extra gnarly. For you on this side. Make sure it's in a reasonably gnarly place for you. All right, so we're getting a little trigger point release, but it's not too painful. Maybe a little moving there. When you're ready, we can transition into that more reclined twist variation. So I'm going to move my block. All right, I'll switch what my legs are doing. Bottom leg straight, top knee bent.
maybe a block under that top knee in some manner. Right, taking the left arm and sliding out to the right. And then adjusting to find a more reclined position. Right, maybe right arm reaches out to the right. Maybe overhead, maybe a little of both, right? Head can turn in some different ways. And we'll chill out here for a little bit. Shoulder will feel different depending on where you put your arm. So make sure that you're not stressing that out inadvertently. You can also prop up your shoulder with a blanket or a pillow. Check your breathing. More deep breaths here. Okay. So coming out of this, we're going to come to the on our backs. So you can just carefully transition there, right? Maybe just take a moment with your feet down and your back down to let those stretches kind of have a chance to settle. All right, one more yin posture before Shavasana. Recline, butterfly. So we're gonna bring the soles of the feet together.
I'll let the knees open out, and I'm gonna start by propping my legs up just to give things a chance to acclimate a little bit better. You can remove your props, right? You can have that all the way down. It's a little friendlier for me if I start here and then see what happens, right? Just kind of finding the shape first. Heels can be closer in or further away, right? No one exact spot. Find what feels like it's going to work the best for you. Arms can rest wherever you like, beside you, overhead, maybe mimicking a diamond shape, maybe hands on your chest, belly to watch your breathing. And you may find if you are starting with props that you can maybe, I've got mind blocks on the middle height after a little bit of acclimating. I'll go down to the lower height, right? So just starting to feel that a little bit more. I'll let that settle for a little bit of time. Decide to lose the props altogether. Taking a few more final cleansing breaths with some nice sighing exhales through the mouth. To set up my Shavasana, I'm going to make myself extra cozy. Right? You may see me look at my watch. Hopefully you're not looking at the video while you're resting in Shavasana. But I'm going to make sure that we're here for enough time to get a nice rest. Yin has a tendency to make me feel a little bit cool, right? It's a cooling practice, not a heat-inducing practice. So I'm going to cover up with a blanket, so you might like that as well. I've got blocks up under my knees. You could do blankets, bolster, right? Anything that helps you feel comfy and helps your low back feel a little bit more settled. Set up and feeling nice and comfy. Close your eyes. And we'll finally just let the breath be more natural and effortless, letting it work on its own as we rest. gently begin to wiggle fingers and toes. Take a nice deep breath. Circle the wrists, ankles. Reach arms overhead and stretch your fingers and toes. Give your knees a hug in toward your chest. Rock a little bit from side to side. And then roll over to your side. Rest there. Very gently press up to a comfortable seat. Close your eyes, bring your hands together at your heart, and take a moment to reflect on this practice and to honor yourself for practicing self-care, showing yourself some love today. Thank you so much for practicing in with me, and I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Namaste.